bugs, cats, hamsters. And then you also have the unusual birdies like tarantulas, alligators, even bugs. Yes, I can work for them. But recently, a new type of birdie pet became a national sensation. These nocturnal marsupials can be found in countries like Australia and UK. What am I talking about? As the title suggests, I'm talking about sugar gliders. I myself have a pair of sugar gliders. Their names are Ashley and Sayuri. Why I would like to talk about sugar gliders is because even though they are not an endangered species, they are, however, not native to Brunei. And thus, not a lot of people are aware of how to take care of them properly. So let me share with you my knowledge, not as an expert, but as an experienced owner. My main focus will be on their diet, their social condition, and their living condition. First off, sugar gliders are omnivores, which means they eat meat and plants. They eat meat for protein, and as for plants, they prefer sugary nectary food. I myself usually feed them proteins such as boiled chicken breast, there's also mealworms, and then there's also eggs. For fruits and vegetables, they need a wide variety, as much as possible, for their optimum health. If you find that you may not have the time to prepare for all this wide variety of food, simple. You go to a grocery store and buy those instant approved diet packages. Two of which I prefer would be the HPW diet as well as the BML diet. If you would like to know more about that, you can talk to me offline. Moving on, the second thing that you need to know about sugar gliders is that they are highly social creatures, like humans. They need and they crave for our attention, because in the wild, in their natural habitat, they live in such big communities. Big colonies. Which is why it's best to keep a pair at least, if not more. And because they need interactiveness, we need to spend time with them every day if you can. Play with them, but if you can't, it's okay. If you're someone like me who's always up and about, bring your own. How? We actually have specialized glider travel bags, or what I would prefer, bonding pouches, which you can just carry inside your shirt or inside your tudong. I'm not wearing one now, by the way. So that you can keep them close to you while they rest or sleep. You don't know how adorable it is to have them near you. Besides that, sugar gliders, they also need a very big space. Now, even though I can't give it a big forest, what I can give it is a big cage, preferably at least 36 inches high and 24 inches wide, at least. Beyond that, sometimes I also like to let them roam around in my room, especially whenever I have free time, because a cage, do you think, is enough for animals that come from the wild? Even we need to roam free, let alone the animals. And of course, being such attractive and active animals, they need accessories, including toys. Their toys can be anything, from something as simple as sticks and ropes, or something a little more complicated, such as exercise wheel, there's also forage chests, pit balls, and so much more. It's also important for you to play with them, because those toys cannot substitute for us trying to bond with them as many. And let me tell you this, once you bond with your guidance, there's an endless possibility of cute faithfulness from them. For example, in my room, once I actually climbed on top of my closet, glided and then straight onto my face. A little painful, but adorable nonetheless. Now, ladies and gentlemen, gliders, taking care of them is not a small issue. Sorry, it's not a small deal. It takes a lot of patience, it takes a lot of commitment. Because these are attention-seeking creatures. That means a big space, toys, accessories, and a large variety of food. Kind of like a hamster-sized puppet. Even though there's a lot of hassle having them, but personally, I don't regret having them because they do hold a space. They do hold a special space in my heart. And when you bond with them, there's an endless possibilities of how much you can make each other happy. And with that, I would like to pass the floor back to our TNE, Mr. Parasite.